Look, that is, I think we can all agree, absolutely horrifying. It brings to mind, you know, similar terror attacks that have happened in some cities. People using their vehicle as a deadly weapon, mowing down people who are in their path. And that's what we saw there. And it was important for you to see that, as difficult as that is to see, because you need to understand that Kathleen Casillo's defense of her actions, who was facing 7 years in prison, by the way, for it, said that the protesters were being too aggressive and she panicked and hit the gas. So what you just saw was many discrete choices to continue to accelerate and then stop and then accelerate and then stop, hitting people and then hitting more people and hitting more people. This was not an incident where everyone massed around the car and then there was a moment of panic, which you're still responsible for what you do. This was many individual choices to do that. But that said, that's my view. Apparently my view was not well represented in the legal deliberations. She is gonna perform 5 hours of community service and we'll see her plea to misdemeanor reckless endangerment get knocked down to disorderly conduct if she fulfills the terms of her plea. They say, by the way, the prosecutors, that they did not pursue more severe plea terms with Ms. Casillo because she had no criminal record, did not leave the scene of her crime, and in their estimation, did not intend to hurt the protesters she hit with her vehicle. Well, it is after all about intentions, I suppose. By the way, she's not the only person that has been let off with barely even a slap on the wrist. There was in Minneapolis, there was a similar instance. A man drove his car into protesters on a highway, charges were dropped. A man who drove his car into protesters in Seattle also had his charges reduced. There was the guy in Texas who was looking at a possible pardon from Greg Abbott for bringing an assault rifle to one of these and gunning down protesters. He might end up walking as well. Nina, it's like the worst kind of Groundhog Day. We just keep seeing this same thing happen.
Yeah, it's disgusting, John. And I argue that these lenient charges and being able to plea has a lot to do with who the protesters are or who they were. And when I say are, because you know they are. But that's really what this boils down to. And as much as people don't want to deal with this, this has very much to do with the race of the protesters, that it was a Black Lives Matter protest. I mean, why the hell was she driving down that street anyway? When you see a whole bunch of people walking down the street in the middle of the street, whether it's a protest or not, your car can be used as a weapon. She did that deliberately, and shame on the prosecutors because she didn't have a previous record. I mean, to you, I mean, it wasn't like she was littering. You know, it's one thing to throw garbage out of your car, for God's sakes, which I think that is criminal in and of itself. Don't get me wrong, it is a crime to do that. I hate people who litter, but I digress. Yeah. She wasn't throwing paper, John, out of her car. She was using her car to plow down people as if she was a bowling ball and they were bowling pins. And there are real life, flesh and blood consequences to that. But she gets to tiptoe through the damn tulips.
Yeah.
The prosecutor is at fault here.
100%. Plain. Yeah. I agree with you on the littering too, by the way. By the way, so we have a comment and Gloating Lizard says, to maintain fairness, John, intent is what a lot of the law is about. No, I understand that. And that's a fine comment. What I am saying is the royal you trying to invoke intent about something that is not disputable, that hitting someone with a car endangers their life. At that point, okay, maybe somehow you didn't intend to do it, but it doesn't matter at that point. Any reasonable person would know what the intent of doing that is. If someone's in front of your hood and you go into them, you are going to damage them. Intent should, to me, not matter at that point. You could shoot a gun at a crowd of people with no intent to hit them, but it doesn't matter how honest you might be in your intent. You very well might hit them. So, and by the way, I'm not frustrated with you. Your comment's totally right, but I think we all understood what the actual intent was. And again, I don't know the person. I don't know how scared she was in the moment or whatever, but I know each of those choices was a choice to risk killing someone. That's what it actually was.
She was in the car though, John. And I get, you know, there have been circumstances where so-called mobs converged on a car, as you laid out. That was not that.
I mean, it certainly didn't look like it.
very clear. And she kept going and stopping and going and going and then plowing through. First of all, why was she, again, why did she take her car down that path? But she couldn't see those people till she got all the way up on them. And she's the one that's scared. Please,
I don't know.
Give me a break. Again, it was because it's a BLM rally and a whole bunch of black people marching down the street. And we know that there are disparate treatments still in this country in the 21st century when the victims are black.
Yeah.
And that's on full display.
By the way,
right there.
100%. You remember the terrible footage of cops? There was one particular video that I can never get out of my head of cop SUVs just plowing into a bunch of people. I never heard about any charges for that either. I mean, look, if they're not going to get a random woman, they're definitely not going to get cops. Let's be clear about that. But yeah, and it's like the right loves to talk about this as a tactic of terrorists. They care so much about it when it's that. But if it's protesters, then they're passing literally passing bills in multiple states trying to make it easier to get off with intentionally hitting people with your car. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.